Hello, Cloud Experts. So let's get started with the AWS introduction and history of AWS as well as the global infrastructure of AWS. My name is Sanjay Kumar and I'm a cloud trainer and consultant. Now let's talk about the brief history of AWS. The AWS was internally launched in Amazon in 2002-2003. However, the first service which was launched is called as SQS, or Simple Queuing Service, in 2004. In 2006, they officially launched AWS with services like SQS, S3 and EC2. SQS is called as Simple Queuing Service, S3 is called as Simple Storage Service, and EC2 is Elastic Compute Cloud. So we'll talk about all these services in some future sessions. In 2007, they launched in Europe and they had 180,000 developers on their platform. In 2010, whole Amazon.com moved over to AWS. In 2012, they launched first reInvent, which is the largest tech event on the planet. And today, they have more than 6,000 functions and services, and AWS is the global leader in the cloud computing market. Now, let's have a look at the AWS global infrastructure. This picture is taken from aws.amazon.com. And if you really need to know more about it, you can simply visit infrastructure.aws. So now when we look at this, it has got 24 different regions which are launched, 77 availability zones, 216 point of presence, where we have 205 edge locations and 11 edge caches, and they have covered 245 countries and territories, and these numbers keeps on changing. So it is good that you are not being tested for these numbers in the AWS certification exams. Now, what are AWS regions? AWS region is a geographic location which consists two or more AGs, which are typically called as availability zones. Some regions can have two AGs and some regions can have up to six availability zones. So a region is a geographic location which can have two or more availability zones depending on the region. A region is a group of multiple data center, and these regions are typically named as EU East 1, EU West 2, etc. And most of the services which are available in AWS are region-based services. However, there are some services which are global services, but mostly services are actually region-based services. Now, what are the availability zones? Availability zones are different cluster of data centers within the AWS region. So each region may have two or more availability zones, and all these availability zones are connected to each other by using high bandwidth and low latency links. Each availability zone can have one or more data centers, and these availability zones are geographically separated from each other with redundant power supplies, redundant networking mechanism, and different kind of connectivity. They are also created in different floodplains and different earthquake zones as well. Now, what are typically data centers? Data centers are a collection of huge computers or servers which will serve have almost infinite capacity. So basically, these data centers are the big racks of servers, and all these resources are pooled in, which is typically called as shared pool of resources. And all these resources can support multi-tenancy kind of architecture, and n number of different users, small or big corporates, can access these resources and can configure these resources by using internet from anywhere in the world. Now, this may be a picture. This is how the AWS data centers typically looks like. So these are the sites where you have AWS data centers available. AWS point of presence, which is typically called as edge location, and these edge locations are closer to the end user and more in number than regions or availability zones. These are typically required to enhance the consumer experience, and these are typically called as content delivery networks, or we call it as CDNs. CDN's services of AWS is called as CloudFront. So CloudFront is the name of the services which is used as CDN in AWS. It can be used for both read and write. We will understand in the further sessions what do we mean by both read and write. Typically, when we talk about edge locations or content delivery networks, what we understand is that they are only used for reading, but in some of the services, these edge locations can be used for writing into it as well. Now, AWS have 216 point of presence, which includes 205 edge locations and 11 edge caches. AWS Pace of Innovation, again this picture is taken from aws.amazon.com. They have more than 6,000 different services and functions available, and they are actually growing these numbers very quickly. And every time you log in into your AWS account, you will see one or the other new services which are available. So they have the great pace of innovation, they have a lot of services available, and these services are being actually growing day by day, and also they are enhancing the consumer experience as well as the network experiences. Now, AWS have something called as which is shared responsibility model. What is shared responsibility? There are two things here. The responsibility of security of the cloud. The security of the cloud is the responsibility of the AWS, and security in the cloud is the responsibility of the customer. So typically what they call it, the shared responsibility model. What do we mean by shared responsibility model? That means security of the cloud is the responsibility of AWS, and the security in the cloud is the responsibility of customer. Now let us understand all the regions, availability zones, edge location, hardware and global infrastructure, compute, storage, databases, networking, and the software available in that. They are all the responsibility of AWS. However, all the things related to the operating systems, network, firewall configuration, platform, applications, identity, and access management, and the customer data is the responsibility of the end customer. Now, typically, how do we look at this? All the things which is related to the infrastructure is the responsibility of AWS. Anything related to the platform and the services is the responsibility of the customer. However, these things will also vary depending on what services are being used and in what kind of service model you are. So if you are in IaaS or PaaS or SaaS, some of these responsibility metrics will change. But this is typically called as AWS shared responsibility model. Now, let us quickly talk about what are the different AWS certification we have. So AWS have various certification available. Some of these things are at foundational level, which is typically called as AWS certified cloud practitioner. Then we have some certificates available at the associate level. So we have AWS certified solution architect in the architect level, and SysOps administrator, and AWS developer. So these three are associate level certification, and then there are two professional level certification, which is AWS Solution Architect Professional and DevOps Engineer Professional. However, they also have some specialty certification related to advanced networking, security, machine learning, Alexa Skill Builder, data analytics, as well as databases. They keep on adding these different certification. So every time when you see, you may find couple of different certification than what is shown in this picture. So that's all in this session. Look forward to see you in the next session. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this, please like this video and subscribe our YouTube channel. For early notification, you can also press the bell icon. If you need any more information, please visit us as www.cloud-training.guru or email us at cloudtrainingguru101@gmail.com. Thank you very much.